Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video on Design Spark Mechanical. And in this video I'm going to show you how you can create repetition. So it means you can have object and you can create repetition on this. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you like my videos, and if you are interested by more, everything is on the first link on the description. This is tutorial to discover the software. This is tutorial to add information. So now if you want a complete course, you want to perfectly master everything in Design Spark Mechanical, first link on the description, you will find a complete course. So let's start with a repetition. The first thing that I'm going to do is to create a sketch. So I'm going to use a sketch mode and select my Z axis here and just be in the top view, create a rectangle directly from the center and just create a rectangle like this with two values. It can be just 12 millimeter by 12 millimeter. Finish my sketch and just create an extrusion. So with my pull tool, I can just click here, create an extrusion. Let's extrude with 60 millimeter. So now I have this element and I have a solid on the left in my construction tree, and I would like to duplicate, create a repetition. So to create repetition, first things to do, you need to click on the move tool. And then you need to activate, you need to select the solid that you want to move. So you can click here. And after to do this work, you have these options, create patterns on this area. You need to activate create patterns. And now the things that I can do, I select for example the front view. And I can go left click on this axis. Oops, let's do this again. Click here, create patterns. And I can drag and move to enter the distance that I want. Let's apply 200 millimeter and press enter. And now you can have another value to work. And between the first distance and the second distance, how many count you want to have. And I would like, for example, 6 count. So I can tap 6. And if you want, you can come back to your distance and you can find the update just like this, just with the left click. And if I want more, I can tap 8 and just click here and it will be updated. And if I finish my work, I just go left click outside. So this is how you can create repetition. Let's create repetition with this element again. I can select my move tool, click on the patterns and create patterns here. If I select my top view, I can click on this green arrow and go in this direction. One more time, I can enter the values that I want. Let's tap again 200 millimeter. And now I can tap the count. So this is the same. If I tap 6, for example, I just go left click and I can activate 6 count. If I want 8, I can tap 8, left click, and I can duplicate like this and just validate. So this is how you can create a linear pattern. Now, if you want to create a circular pattern, let's click here, right click, delete. First things to do, I'm going to create a sketch with a circle in the middle. So click on the Z axis, top view, and create a first circle just around this area with maybe 20 millimeter, finish the sketch. Let's create an extrusion like 40 millimeter. And let's create another sketch. Click on the sketch mode and activate directly the top view again. But here I don't want to be on this axis, so just go left click on this area, select new sketch plane and just work with the Z axis and activate the top view. Let's create a second circle. I'm going to position a circle around this area. Not enter a specific dimension, just put a circle between this one and this one. Finish the sketch and create an extrusion of this second circle. I can click here, let's apply 20 millimeter extrusion. And I would like to repeat this circle around the main circle. This cylinder around the main cylinder. So how to do this? First, I'm going to select my top view. Then I activate the Move tool. I select the solid that I want to repeat, so it means the second, this solid. And I can activate create patterns. One of the problems that I have is I need to change the center point, because if I don't change the center point, nothing special will happen. To change the center point, you can click here, anchor point. And now you can drag and move, left click this point, and you can drag and move. The aim is to position on this area perfectly in this center. And now from this solid, the center point, transformation point will be here. So it's perfect. I can come back with this tool, select, click here. And if I just go left click, I can turn like this. Turn like this. And you can select the value that you want. I can just apply, for example, 90 degrees here. But as you can see, I forgot to activate pattern. So I'm going to show you again because the pattern was not activated. So I select my move tool, select the solids, change the transformation point. You can also directly drag and move the transformation point. Sometimes you don't need to click here. And you need to reactivate create patterns. And now if I turn, take a glance, depending on the number of degrees, you can make a complete turn or not. The aim is just to, if you want to make the maximum, you just turn, 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 turn. And until you arrive with all this element, you stop left click. And now you have more options. You can apply the count. If I want just 4, I can apply 4, press enter. And you can have the number of degrees, but the two are in link. So it means if you tap 4, you will have 90 degrees. At the same time, if I tap 45 degrees, I will have 8. So whether you tap the degrees, whether you tap the count. If I tap 30 degrees, by default, I will have count 12. But if I want, for example, 20, by default, I will have 18 degrees. So you can apply the degrees or you can apply the count depending of what you want to do. Let's apply 12. And at the end, you just need to go left click outside and that's it. Something also that I wanted to show you if I just come back is you have a distance here. So you have the distance by default. If you want to increase, if I want 40 millimeter, I can extend for 40 millimeter or just reduce. So you can work with these three values. And it is great because now I created this pattern with multiple solids around my main solids. So this is how in Design Spark Mechanical, you will be able to create patterns. So let's delete that. It is the end of this video. If you like, subscribe to this YouTube channel. A lot of content about CAD software, 3D modeling software, graphic design software. Animation software also. Subscribe to this channel. First link on the description. You are interested by more. You want to master Design Spark Mechanical. This is a complete course. This is my complete course in a nice structure. Many hours of training videos. You will be able to learn everything about this software. And I'll add this on the first link on the description. And on this channel for a next video, next tutorial video, see you. Ciao, ciao.